Guys, what's up? In today's video, we'll be talking about filters, access controllers, and class-level permissions, so let's get straight to it. We all know that a huge part of maintaining a successful app involves managing all of the data that lies under the surface. This means spending a lot of time using the DB browser. It not only helps us view but also edit our app's data easily. However, many apps have classes with thousands of rows, and this can sometimes make it very difficult to find the row that you're looking for. To help with this problem, there is a filtering feature. It lets you filter the data by conditions. So here it is. This is the column that we'll be filtering. Then we have the condition right here. And finally, we have the parameter. So let's see how it works. I'll use the time zone column, and I know that we have some European users of the application, so I would like to know their total number. Let's see what happens. As you see, we have 12 objects found. This is something, by the way, which is not present in Parse open source dashboard. We have added it. You see the total number of filtered and found objects right here. Another interesting thing that you may like about our filtering feature is the contained in condition. It is also something that is exclusive for SashiDo and is not present in Parse open source dashboard. It will help you find different objects in the same massive and combined conditions. So let me show you what I mean. For example, let's check our app's Android as well as iOS devices. We'll choose device type and we'll then choose contained in. We want to check the total number of iOS as well as Android devices. So this is the condition that I will be adding. Okay, so first I'm going to add Android and then iOS. It takes a couple of seconds, and as you can see right here, we have the total number of filtered objects, which are device type Android and iOS. By the way, the audience creation of push notifications works analogically to this. You can use multiple channels. As you can see, the filters make it easier for you to sort records and manage your app easily. Now let's proceed with access control lists and class level permissions. So when talking about ACLs and CLPs, we are actually talking about security. Security is one of the most crucial aspects of releasing a production app, and there are a lot of ways you can secure your app. One thing is using master key so that only the people who have it can access your data. Then you also have ACLs, also known as access control lists, and CLPs, known as class level permissions, and last but not least, you have cloud code. However, the easiest way to lock down your app is with class level permissions. Almost every class that you create should have these permissions tweaked to some degree. For classes where every object has the same permissions, class level settings will be most effective. If you need different objects to have different permissions, then you better use access level lists. Class level permissions allow you to quickly set permissions for an entire class at once. Let's see how it works. We go to the security section right here. By default, the public can read or write. However, you can always change this. For example, we can now decide that we only want to allow the public to read and not write. We just save the CLP like this. Then we can, for example, give a specific user of ours access to the class, and so that they can not only read but write. Let's choose one of our users and give them access to the installations class so that they can read and write to it. Let's say that we'll be choosing this user here. So we'll be returning to the installations class. We'll go to security again. So we go right there. Type the name of the user, and here it is. We are giving them permissions to read and write. We save the CLP, and basically that's it. Right now the public can read to this collection of hours, and the user that we have just added will be able to read and write. Often, the different objects in a class will need to be accessible by different people. For that, you have to use an access control list. An access control list specifies a set of users who can read or write an object's data. By default, the ACLs are public read and write, just like the CLPs, however, this can be changed. So, let's say, for example, that we want a very specific record in our collection to be written and readable only by a specific user. We will use the same user as before a moment. So let's say that this is the record that we would like to be readable and writable by only one user. We'll click on the ACL column. As you can see right now, the public can read and write. Let's say we'll be allowing them to only read. Then we'll add the user. And we'll give them access to read and write. We save the ACL and that's it. If you want to protect this specific record, you can even hide it from the public so that they can't read or write and only the user that you're giving access to can edit it. I will include more info on the ACL as well as CLP in our filters in the description of the video, so if you're interested, you can go check it out. That was basically it for today, folks. I hope the information was useful to you. In our next video, which will be uploaded next Tuesday, we'll be talking about Cloud Code. We'll be discussing how you can activate it, how you can connect it to your GitHub account, etc. Thank you very much for the attention, guys, and see you next week. Bye for now.